Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are safe and sound. So as we have already covered question number 1 to 5 in the online class of exercise 9.2, now I am here with question number 6 to 10. So there are also so many new concepts which we are going to learn in these questions. So we will go question wise and go through with these new concepts. So let me read the question number 6 is, compare the two line segments PQ and RS using a divider. So before using a divider, first of all, let us know about a divider. What is a divider, children? A divider is an geometrical object like this. This is looking like a compass, of course, but in compass we have one pointed end and one side we are placing the pencil, but here in both the arms we have the pointed end. And how to use it, children? See, so the distance between the end points can be changed by opening and closing the arms, as I'm doing like this. If I open it, the distance is changing. If I open it more, it will be more changed. So let us see how to use the divider for comparing these two line segments. So first of all, let me open this divider and place it at any one of the endpoint. Either you can put on the Q or on P. So I'm putting on Q and opening my divider. Till then I have to place it on P. So this is how we are going to open this divider, and this is the distance between point P and point Q. This is the distance between point P and point Q, and we don't have to disturb the distance between these two arms, and we are going to place it on any of the point S or R. So I'm placing it on S, and this is here. So as you can see, the distance of PQ was this, and if we are comparing with this line segment, the distance is here. If it is Q, it is P. So that means PQ is shorter than RS. Did you notice, children? PQ is shorter than RS because this is the needle of, or the point of the divider is placing between R and S. So the answer will be PQ is smaller than RS. What if, children, if PQ, if the point will be here, the R point is here, this side. So what will be the answer? Yes, of course, PQ equals to RS because both the length are same. And what if PQ distance is this much? So when you are placing it here, it is going far away from R. So that means that time PQ will be greater than this. So it depends on the distance of the arms. If it is lying in between, that means the initial line was shorter. If it is lying on the same points, that means both the lines are equal, line segments are equal. And if it is crossing over the point like this, so that means the initial line was bigger than that. So here in this case, PQ is smaller than RS, so we are going to write down PQ, line segment PQ is smaller than line segment RS. I hope, children, you have understood this. Now let us move to the next question, that is, verify that AE equals to AB plus BC plus CD plus DE. Okay, so for this, children, I need to make a line, a big line segment I have made already drawn here. And then afterwards, make some points. I have already made A, B, C, D, E. You have to make some points. And then afterwards, measure the length of AB. I have measured it as 2 cm. Measure the length of BC. It is 3 cm. Measure the length of CD is 2 cm. And DE is 4 cm. And measure the whole length from A to E. That is 11 cm, which I have written here. So now, how to verify this question? Very simple. we need to put the values of these, whatever we have got from this figure. So as we have measured AE equals to 11 centimeters, so I have written here. The length of AB is 2, so I have written here 2 centimeters. The length of BC is 3 centimeters, so I have written here BC is equal to 3 centimeters. CD 2 centimeter. Then DE is 4 centimeter. Then we need to add, because this is a single digit, so it will remain same like this, and we need to add the right hand side values. 2 + 3 + 2 + 4 will be 11. So 11 centimeter equals to 11 centimeter, hence verified. Hence we have proved this equation that AE equals to AB plus BC plus CD plus DE. Okay, so now let us move to the next question, that is 8 question number. In each of the following cases, state whether you can draw the line segments on the given surface. So here you need to tell, as this kind of question we have already done in question number like 1 to 5. So similarly, these are some objects and we need to tell that are we able to draw the line segment on these objects or not. So the curved surface, first example is the curved surface of a cone. So for cone, children, you must be remembering a birdie cap or an ice cream cone. So the curved surface, what is the curved surface? Curved surface is, if I am going to draw this ice cream cone, so this surface, this is the surface, this round surface, this is the curved surface of the cone. So can we draw a line segment on the curved surface? No, because the line segment is a straight geometrical figure. So we can only draw the line segment on the flat surfaces, not on the curved surfaces. So answer will be no. Face of a cuboid. So let me have an example. This is a cuboidal shape, cuboidal figure. So surface of a cuboid, this is the face of the cuboid. If I'm going to draw a line segment over here on this one, it is gonna draw. So the answer, because this is a flat surface, so the answer will be yes. Okay, now base of a cone, again we have got the example of cone. So cone base will be, suppose the birdie cap is here and it is solid. So the base is this. So of course the base is flat. So on the base or on the flat surface, we can easily draw the line segment. So the answer will be yes. Surface of an egg. Egg is in some ovarical shape, oval shape, oval 3D shape. So that is also has a curved surface. So that means we are not able to draw the line segment on the curved surface. Surface of an orange. Orange is also a spherical shape. So on orange as well, we are not able to draw the line segment, because line segment or line or ray can be drawn on the flat surface like the notebook. This is flat, so here we can draw, but we can't draw on the spherical or curved surface. Now let us move to the next question, children. Question number 9. How many lines can pass through one given point or two given point? This type of questions already we have discussed in exercise 9.1. One given point. Suppose there is a one given point. So we can draw so many lines. You are not required to draw the lines or line segment. Just I am giving through the example that this is the point and we can draw infinite number of line or line segments through one given point. This is already we have discussed. This is just to recall you. No need to draw it. Then two given points. Of course, when we have two given points, we can draw only one straight line using these two points. So only one line. Now children, name the points which are in the exterior of the closed figure, in the interior of the closed figure, on the boundary of the figure, closed figure. So there are three concepts again: exterior, interior, and on the boundary. So as the name suggests, exterior means outer word. So this is the closed figure. Whatever points are, let me focus more, whatever the points are exterior means outside of this circle. That means this is the point P, point X, point V, point Z. But children, do you think S is also the exterior? It is written outside. No, we are not talking about the alphabet. We are talking about this point. So point is on the boundary of circle. So it will not come in this category, in the exterior category. So in exterior, we have only four points: Z, V, P, and X, which we have written here: X, P, V, and Z. Next is in the interior of the closed figure. Interior, as the name suggests, interior means inside. So point Q, point W, point O, point T, and point R are these the interior points. That means they are lying inside this closed figure. So point Q, T, O, W, and R are the interior points. Now next, last is on the boundary of the closed figure. Boundary of the closed figure, that I have just told you right now. Boundary, this is the boundary. So whatever the point is lying on the boundary, over the boundary, like this, here. So these are the points. Anyone, any other point? No, only these two points are on the boundary. So the answer will be U and S. So I hope, children, you have understood these all questions. Rest of the questions we will do in the next online class. So till then, complete your work, stay safe, stay healthy. Bye bye.